Oh. Oh. Oh.
We just can't catch a break. That's a good bull, but cow and a calf. As we're coming in to hunt this morning.
Life offers no guarantees, but the one thing we've learned for sure is that the time we have is indeed precious. The more time we spend with family, friends, and with nature can make the difference between living a good life and living a great one. Join us on our quest to be participants rather than observers, to learn from our mistakes, to share our successes and our failures as we spend all of the time we have chasing our dreams, fueling our passion, and fueling the fire in the great outdoors.
Yeah.
was so close. If it didn't have a cow with it, I might have got a shot at that bull. He was within my wheelhouse for sure. Wow, that was exciting.
Hey folks, welcome back to the program. Now, every year our moose camp is a long camp. It's important for us to get as many people, as many pro staff out into the forest and out into moose country as possible. We go at it hard for rifle and for archery. This rifle season, Warren and his son Justice got to go out for bulls again, and Justice was on the gun. Warren is an expert caller and he always gets you in on some bulls. After that close encounter with that young bull, Warren and Justice head north about 5 kilometers. Lo and behold, they find the exact same moose, and this time he puts on a show. Thank you.
Ruth.
It's so exciting when you get up close and personal with those big bulls. Even the young ones seem big when you're staring them eye to eye. Every time you go out and have an interaction with one of your quarry or with one of the animals you're pursuing, there's something to learn. How they respond, how you respond, it all adds up to eventually harvesting one of those bulls.
Bye.
hit him high. He was so close, he was 15 yards and I had my 30 yard. I didn't want to let down. But I saw blood come out. But I hit him high. We're gonna give him some time. Like a half an hour at least, but and then we'll go check for blood. I'm gonna get my orange on. Oh, come on. Please. Oh. Isn't great. There's some bubbles in the first part of it. We've given it about a half an hour, but it's washing out in this drizzle and we're just tracking the tracks, but it's a pretty clear line of where he went. I just can't find any more blood. I'm hoping that those triple blades while he's running is actually cutting in there. Maybe I got the top of a lung. Man, this is the part where you're just playing it over and over and over again. Why didn't I hold a little bit lower? But so much adrenaline. We're just gonna tiptoe through here. Yeah, baby! Yes! That's 6 years! 6 years, Johnny! Oh! Oh, man! I cannot! Oh! Dude!
Where is he?
Oh, man. He's down. He's down. I got my first bull with a bow. What a crazy hunt. That just was unbelievable. Come on, let's go check him out.
Oh, yeah, he's down. He's down. Look at my first bull. With a bow. Man. He's good too. He's a good little bull.
The Bowtech solution, Dennis Grattan with the solution. Oh man, let's check him out. We've been at this so long to try and get this done with a bow and we skipped the morning hunt because it was raining so hard and we thought we'd come out for a little trip. This is a cool little rack.
probably 30 inches. Oh man, I couldn't be prouder. Oh geez. I'm at a loss for words, and that doesn't happen too often. All right, we're gonna go back to camp. Diane and Aspen are here this weekend. We get Warren and John Ainsley. Steph and Zigzag are here filming. We got some work cut out, but we're out here fueling our passion, fueling the fire, and getting outdoors. We have an awesome season 6 in store for you guys, because we've been working our tails off to bring these memories to you guys. This is just fantastic. We'll see you next week.